Paperboy, stopping at nothing in his valiant effort to save this land from TV journalism.
Hello and welcome to another episode of the Heavy Metal Gamer. Now, my original next review was going to be The Legend of Zelda, but since my computer decided to be a real bitch whore, crash on me, and I had to restore back to factory settings, I lost all the footage, the commentary, and even my intro. So, with that being said, I have put that review on hold for now, but I will tell you right now, I will be reviewing that game this year. So, since that review went to hell, I want to do a review on a classic arcade game. That's right, Paperboy. Paperboy was developed and published by Atari Games. It was originally released in the arcade in 1984. It was ported to many different consoles and computers, such as the Amiga, Amstrad CPC, Apple IIgs, Apple II, Atari ST, BBC Micro, BlackBerry Phone, Commodore 64, Commodore 16, PC, Electron, Game Boy, Game Boy Color, Game Gear, Sega Genesis, Atari Lynx, NES, Sega Master System, Game Boy Advance, and the ZX Spectrum. Holy damn hell, that is a lot of consoles and computers to be ported to. I would love to review every single one of them, but I'm not going to make the review 40 minutes long. I mean, I don't want you falling asleep about 12 minutes in, which you probably will on this one. So I'm just going to review the arcade version and the Apple II, Game Boy, MS-DOS, and Sega Genesis port. Now, in this game, you can choose between three difficulties. Those difficulties are Easy Street, Middle Road, and Hard Way. If you can't figure out which one is the easiest or the hardest, then, well, maybe you shouldn't be playing this game. I think it's cool how they labeled the difficulties after streets, roads, and so on. That shows a little bit of creativity. I mean, it could have just said easy, medium, hard, and then that would just be bland and boring. Not saying all games that do that are bland and boring, but it's kind of cool to see something refreshing. There really is no story behind Paperboy. You just play as a paperboy on a bicycle delivering papers around the neighborhood. You must attempt to deliver papers daily to subscribing customers. You have to avoid hazards along the streets and the sidewalks and get through the training course at the end of the street. Now you're probably thinking, Aaron, you forgot about one thing. One of the biggest things of this game. You're supposed to vandalize the non-subscriber's house. Well, a normal paperboy would just not vandalize. I mean, that's not cool, that's rude. Plus, you could get in big trouble. But in the world of video games, and in my world, go for it. Just bash the hell out of their windows. Oh, and remember this, you get a score for damage done on non-subscriber houses. How great is that? Now, if you miss or damage a subscriber's house, then they will end up bitching you out, and then they will unsubscribe, and then you have to work your way to gain them back. Sometimes it can be easy, sometimes it can be tough. The graphics for Paperboy on the arcade are pretty damn good. The game is very colorful. The level designs don't really change except for the hazards and so on, as they will end up showing up more and more, and the game will get more difficult later on through the week. If you do hit one of the hazards, you will get two type of comic book style collisions. The first one, it will come up with just symbols, probably saying a cuss word, or it will say smack. I think that's pretty cool too. I really like that. Now, some of the hazards and obstacles are quite funny. You will have your fire hydrants, storm drains, cars, skateboarders, and so on. But then you will have obstacles like breakdancers, kids with radio-controlled cars, kids with bombs, drunks, dogs, black cats, two morons fist fighting in the street, and more. This is a really crazy neighborhood. I mean, I never even had a neighborhood like this. Would I really want to? Well, you know what? Why not? Because you could sit outside and watch all the stuff happen and sit there and laugh. Maybe get it on video for YouTube. The music and sound effects are pretty good. I wouldn't say the music is the most memorable arcade game music I've ever heard, but I like it. The sound effects are done quite well. They are pretty simple when it comes to sound effects. Nothing real special, except there is one thing that I find that's really cool in this game. The voiceover. When you first start playing Paperboy, and when you select your difficulty, you hear a voiceover. Or when you hit an obstacle, you will hear that same voiceover again, and it'll say a bunch of different things. Now, the voiceover is digitized, and if I had to compare it to anything, I would compare it to the Intellivision voice modulator, which was an add-on to the Intellivision. If you've ever seen the Angry Video Game Nerd review of the Intellivision and ColecoVision, you will know what I'm talking about. Now, I mentioned earlier about a training course. Well, at the end of each level, the training course is on a dirt course where you will have to watch out for hazards and hit the targets with your papers. If you do crash on the training course or run out of time, you will not lose a life. If you get to the end, you will get a bonus added to your score for damage done to the unsubscribing houses and whatever time is remaining left on the training course. I really like this portion of the game. I think it's fun and sometimes can be quite difficult, especially in the later days of the week or in another difficult. difficulty. The controls are pretty good and quite responsive. They might be a little too responsive at times on the steering, especially if you're going at a pretty good pace on the bike. Of course, you can slow down, which is quite nice, especially if you want to take your time and do a lot of damage to the unsubscribing houses, or if you want to hit it in the mailbox. Hit it in the mailbox, that doesn't sound right, but it was funny, right? If I had to rate the arcade version of Paperboy, I would give it a 9 out of 10. A classic arcade game and so fun to play. Even though I didn't get to play the game in the arcade when I was younger, I enjoy playing it on MAME. Now this review is far from over, and I still have some ports I want to review. With the ports of Paperboy I'm going to review, I'm going to mainly focus on the graphics, music and sound effects, controls, and maybe if there's a few different things from the arcade version. So I want to start off with the Apple II version of Paperboy, which was developed by Atari and published by Mindscape. It was released in 1988, the same year I was born. Now, the Apple II computer has kind of a soft spot in my heart. When I was in grade school, we had these computers. This was back around 1994, 1995. I remember being in kindergarten, and we would have a computer class every Thursday, and we would play on the Apple II computers. Every time I see one or watch a video about one, it brings back a lot of memories of being a real young kid and playing educational games on them. The graphics for Paperboy on the Apple II are nowhere near as good as the arcade version. Now, I know the Apple II has tons of limitations. There's only so much it can do. And there's only a few colors, depending on how you want to play the game, really. You can play it in color, or in the orange colors, or even the green colors, which is just orange screen, green screen with a black background. I am playing in color, and I only counted about 3 or 4 different colors, maybe 5. I can't say they are completely horrible because of all the limitations, but they are probably the worst out of all the ports I'm reviewing. I mean, look at the title screen. That is pretty ugly looking. When it comes to music and sound effects, you only have sound effects, no music. And once again, that's probably because of the limitations. It would be nice to have a little bit of music somewhere in the game, though. The controls are flat out horrible. Moving around is slow, and I mean very slow. The controls have a slow response time, and you might as well just go in a straight line and get hit by a car and throw papers and wish yourself the best of luck at hitting the mailboxes. If I had to rate the Apple II port of Paperboy, I would give it a 4.5 out of 10. I will give it this score because it was an attempt to put the game on a computer with tons of limitations, especially when you compare it to the arcade version. The chances of getting to the end of the level are pretty low, as the controls will ruin it for you, and the gameplay is really slow. This is one port you should probably stay away from. Now, keeping with the computer game theme, I want to show you the MS-DOS port, and hopefully it will be better than the Apple II port. So this port of Paperboy was also developed by Atari Games and published by Mindscape. It was released in 1988, although I have read that on some sites it says it was released in 1986. Also, if you look at the title screen, it says Tengen was involved with the game. Oh, that's quite interesting. I have to laugh. It says the graphics were done by Paul Walker. Isn't he supposed to be driving cars in movies or something? Okay, I know that was a horrible joke. Some of you might get what I was trying to do there. The others that don't, I'm sorry. That was horrible. The graphics for the MS-DOS port of Paperboy are better this time around. The game is a lot more colorful than the few colors on the Apple II. Matter of fact, you can choose between 4 colors and 16 colors on the MS-DOS port. I am playing the game in 16 colors, and I think it looks pretty good. The music and sound effects this time around are not bad. This time you have music, which is nice, but you only get the music at the title screen. Not when you're going around throwing papers and so on. Which is better than the Apple II port, once again, because in the Apple II port, you had no music. You just had a few sound effects. The controls are a little better, although they are very slippery and it almost seems like you're out of control at times. Especially if you're going way too fast and some of the sidewalks are very narrow, and there's some gates blocking some of the sidewalks, and you're going to end up crashing into them. That is one thing I noticed about this port. The house designs are a little different, and some of them have gates set up on the sidewalk, where you will end up crashing through them. That can be a little bit annoying, but I guess that's part of the game. I guess that's how they wanted to make it. If I had to rate the MS-DOS port of Paperboy, I would give it a 6 out of 10. A lot better than the Apple II version, especially when it comes to the graphics, music and sound effects, and even the controls. Although the controls still have some issues, but not as bad as the Apple II port. Alright, this time let's check out a handheld port of Paperboy. And a matter of fact, I have this game on the Game Boy, and I used to play it all the time. And it's probably one of my top played and favorite Game Boy games. Now, like the other two games, the Game Boy port was developed by Atari Games and published by Mindscape. And this time it was released in 1990. The graphics for the Game Boy port are pretty good. Now, yes, there's only two colors, and it's only black and white. But for a Game Boy game, I really can't complain at all. I mean, you could always get a hold of the Game Boy Color version, or play the game on the Super Game Boy, which was an add-on for the Super Nintendo. I think the sprites were done well, and I just like the screen resolution. You seem to be zoomed in a little bit more. The music and sound effects are not bad. Not much for sound effects compared to the arcade version, but the music this time around plays throughout the level, and it's pretty good music. Now, sure, it's not the most memorable music in gaming, but if you play it long enough, you'll get it stuck in your head for a while, which is kind of cool. The controls are pretty good, a little slow at times, but way better than the PC ports. Some of the control issues could be user error, but all in all, they're pretty good, and I really can't complain. If I had to rate the Game Boy port of Paperboy, I would give it an 8 out of 10. A really good handheld port, and to be honest, I really enjoy it. Especially when I was a kid and going on vacation with my family, I would bring my Game Boy and all my games, two sets of batteries, and play games for hours. Especially Paperboy. Now you're probably wondering why I'm not reviewing the NES port. Well, if you look at the Game Boy port and the NES port, they are the same game. The NES port might have a little bit better graphics, just a little bit, but not enough to really tell the difference. As you can see, the only real difference is the addition of color. So I didn't feel it was needed to review it. I may do a Let's Play on the NES port at a later time. Okay, on to the last port that I want to review, and this is the one I know the most, and that is the Sega Genesis port. The Sega Genesis port of Paperboy was developed by Atari and published by Tengen. It was released in 1991. Now, if I'm saying Tengen wrong, I've heard it two different ways. I've heard Tengen and Tengen, so I'm gonna say it whatever way I want to. I'm sure somebody's gonna be like, "Ah, you're saying it wrong! You're saying it wrong! You're saying it wrong, Aaron! You suck, heavy metal gamer! You don't know nothing about games!" I'm sure I'll get a PM from somebody, or even a comment, but you know what, I've been saying it that way for years, so I'm just gonna stick with it. The graphics for the Sega Genesis port are pretty damn good. I think the graphics are the best on this home console port. The level layouts are nice, and the character sprites are done very well. I personally think the graphics look just as good as the arcade version. The music and sound effects I really enjoy, especially the music. For some reason, it just fits the game perfectly. Now, like the arcade version, this port does have voiceovers, and it sounds a little bit muffled, but it's really cool to see that in this game. I remember when I was a kid going around saying, "That guy's wasted." Especially when I was at the store with my parents and the town drunks walked by. And they would be wasted, too. The controls are very simple and easy, and I feel that they respond quite well. I would have to say they are just as good as the arcade version, and I think the steering is a little bit better this time around because it's not as slippery as the arcade version. All in all, I don't think I can really complain. If I had to rate the Sega Genesis port of Paperboy, I would give it a 9 out of 10. I have to say it's about as good as the arcade version. Sure, I play it more than any other port, but the game is so much fun to play. If you have never played Paperboy, then get away from your Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 and your Battle Fart 3 and fire up your Xbox 360 if you have one and find the game on the Xbox Live Arcade. Or if you have some retro consoles and you don't play them anymore, dust those things off and go to your local game store and find the Sega Genesis or the Game Boy port. Or go on eBay and you could probably find the games on there for cheap. Now, there are a few sequels to Paperboy. There was Paperboy 2 and Paperboy on the Nintendo 64. In 2009, a version came out on the iPhone, and it looks pretty good. Unfortunately, I don't own an iPhone. I just have a regular cell phone, so I won't be able to review it or play it. I do own a copy of Paperboy 2 on the Super Nintendo, so I plan to review that later on. I hope you enjoyed this big review of the classic game Paperboy. Thanks for watching.